So that's how the life went on. But inner being was still seeking the way and methods of giving a mass realization. My father said, before you do not develop this technique of giving a mass realization, don't talk of religion. Let nobody know that you know anything about it, because they'll crucify you. Or he was rather worried that people won't understand, or you may write another Bible or Gita, no use. First of all, you must give them realization. If they get the realization, then they will realize that there's something above this human awareness. For example, he always used to give an analogy. Supposing you are born on the 10th story and everybody is on the ground, you must at least make them climb 2 stories so they know there's something above it. Otherwise, no use talking about it. And he said this is the mistake between the saints and the incarnations, was that they never realized that these people are still on the ground. They have to still enter into the building. So that is what you have to be very careful, that first of all you must give realization to people. So I was seeking the ways and methods, working it out inside myself through my own style of meditation, in the sense that I would work out all the permutations and combinations. Supposing I met one person, then I would see what problems that person had, how you can overcome it like that. I would try to study that person internally. And I went to many people to find out, but I found they were great hypocrites. I saw so many of these gurus. Most of them, I saw them, I was surprised they were all hypocrites, money making and this thing. And also I went to Rajneesh also to see him. Then he said that I should come to his program. I didn't know what sort of a man, because he was talking about Gita and big things. I thought he might be knowing something about it. Went there, but my husband said, no, I won't allow you to go to his camp. So he arranged his own bungalow and all that for me. So I went down there. There I couldn't see all the things that were going on. And that is the day, somehow or other, I said I must open the last chakra. So the last chakra was open. And I saw the Kundalini, which is the primordial force within us, which is the Holy Ghost within us, rising like a telescope, opening out. And then I saw the whole thing open, and a big torrential rain of grace started flowing through my head all over. As if, and I felt I'm lost now, I'm no more there, it's only the grace is there, that is there. I saw it completely happening to me. And but I was amazed that when I went to Rajneesh, you see, because before going I had to say goodbye, he never realized what had happened or anything, you see. So I was surprised. I said, this man doesn't know anything about God. And then I discovered that they were all hypocrites and telling lies. So in 1973, this happened on the 5th of May, 70, 1970, 5th of May. And just after that, we had a very big lecture in Jahangir Hall. That's a very big hall. And thousands of people had come. I told them very frankly that these are all thugs and these are like these hypocrites. Some of them are demonic, some are evil people. I took their names, everything. I told them, don't go near them. And there were so many others whom I told these things very clearly. And they got frightened. They said, you shouldn't say like this, they will come and murder you. They'll do. I said, let them come and murder me. But nobody did anything. Nobody even went to the courts. And that's how, you see, they tried to bring bad name to me. They paid money to the newspapers to publish things against me, because I said you cannot pay money. So they thought that I was just trying to, you see, harm them by saying such a thing, that you can't earn money in the name of God. If it's a job, you can do it, but God's work is not a job. And the struggle started from the day I started giving realization. And I started with one lady who got realization first. Then we got about 12 people who got realization. In 2 years, I got only about 14 people realization. Then gradually, when 14 people got realization, then many others started getting realization. But I started also curing people, because that was helping a lot. Then my husband got elected to this post and we had to come to London. So when I came to London, we had one program in Bharati Vidya Bhavan, they arranged it. So the Indians abroad are not so much interested in God, they are more interested in money. So none of the Indians stayed there, they all ran away. And only the foreigners who were there were about 7 hippies. So I had to work on them, 7 hippies, for 4 years I was working on them to give them realization. Very difficult, you see. Their liver was bad, they had ill health, their head was off, terrible times. But in between I used to go to India. And in India also the work was done. For 3 months always I would be in India. So we started work in the villages, especially surprisingly, where my forefathers were ruling in that area, the work started moving in a very big way. And there then we started taking some people from India. Then some people came from Australia to India, like that. And the work started moving in those directions. Then gradually the work improved and people found that this is the way we can transform ourselves. Many people were taking drugs or alcoholic or mad people or cancer people, they felt better, then they got cured. And it was established that Sahaja Yoga is something very important. Now, when I travel all over the world, you see, first my husband used to pay for everything. Wherever I went, he had to pay or any expenses he used to do for me. Gradually, then now these people pay for my travel, but otherwise they don't have to pay for anything else. That's how we started our work. There was a lot of opposition, and the media people would never understand it because it was no such a sensation, as you can say, nothing to people feel excited. But in a way, it's a very great thing because if this is the solution for the whole world, one should try to do it. Then we had very great people who came to Sahaja Yoga, like we can say the Hague High Court judge, who is now the president, who has given Nicaragua judgment. He and many lawyers and many barristers. We have one barrister here from Algeria, and doctors. And then they took over and they started helping me out how to propagate Sahaja Yoga. But it was a difficult task in the West. Of course, in India it spread very fast in the villages. But city people in India also are westernized and they start analyzing. They don't know much about our past, they don't know anything about our heritage that we have, our kundalini and all that. But some people do know about self-realization. But these gurus could not stick on in India because nobody would accept them, so they all ran away abroad. And that was something, a blessing for me also, because I didn't have to fight them there. And it started working out, and then people found that it helps in every way, and they found so many miracles about it, and that's how Sahaja Yoga got settled quite a lot. But still, I would say that we have not been to certain countries so far, and in the West, I would say that so much work has still to be done.